assistance. Got the handle of the sword is here on my left.
I did a nice job.
I'm giving it to your
opponent.
This is a signal that you can draw the sword against me at any time. He's giving me an opening. It's a sign of respect.
What you want today?
So he's giving it with a sign of respect, a sign of his feeling. He's giving it with the handle on my right and the blade. Also, as I said, that you should not leave, lose your gaze together with the opponent. So, Osensei's words were, you shouldn't just stare into your opponent's eyes. Your spirit will be absorbed by your opponent if you look into the opponent's eyes. You have to look at the entire body of your opponent. So, we have the Moai between us. The best thing is to look at the your opponent's feet. You shouldn't be doing that. That's strange. So, Isan Sensei would like very much if you could have that feeling of understanding for this in this circumstance. So now we're having the feeling of entering the dojo for the first time. And so people are walking forward, coming into the dojo. There are people that are holding the sword in their left hand already. It's actually, you've got to keep the sword in a good firm position at the side of your body, along. Putting it at the side of your body, keeping it in that position. So, now we're pointing in the opposite direction. And try walking as if you're entering the dojo for the first time. And turn around, please. Separate a little bit, make a little bit more space between you. Now have a seat, please. Okay, you're in the dojo now. Now try to have a seat. So you're sitting down with the right leg first, putting the sword to your right with the blade inside. Now you bring the sword to your front. Sword handle to the left. And then you bow, please. If the sword is too close to your body, you will have to bow over the sword. Either that, or you will have to put your hands in this unnatural position in order to perform the bow. So you should know how much distance you need between yourself and the sword, where to put your hands. So put the sword in the correct position so that you have room to put your hands when you bow. Try it again, please. Everybody did very well. Now, bring it to the left-hand side. And, standing up. Left foot forward. And, try standing up.
Yeah, good.
brincar na água.
All right?
Mare para os caras na água, né?
Be careful around you, please.
Aí quando eu olhar, dizem nós.
Now we're drawing the sword.
Aí, a mais um.
And stand in your light, please. Most people, you know how to hold the sword correctly, right? Lift up your hand, please. This is called Skangashira, the end of the handle. Your little finger should be half on and half off the end. Either it's on the right hand side or stepping forward on the left. No matter which one you do, when you go to the left, so you're not extending your power on the left hand because you're not covering the sword with your hand properly. Using the palm of your hand on the end of the sword. That way you can put power into the
seat.
Half of the finger, the little finger of your hand. There's a lot of importance in this, a lot of meaning in this. So the idea is, it's just not a question of hitting with the sword and thrusting. You should be able to use the full power of your body and extending it through the sword towards your
opponent.
So in regards to both the sword as well as the joe, she really had this feeling of true intention, shinken, when using these weapons. Let's try this a
little bit.
So we don't have that much time for doing the suguri. He also thinks that you do a very good practice in the suguri. So so he would like you to try to understand the feeling and the importance of this grip using the little finger, half of the little finger on and off the sword. He would like you to to understand this movement. So in Kamai, please. Be careful behind you, everybody. When you're swinging back. So, and ski on the same foot forward. At this point here,
ski
where you are, start where you are. Remember, back hands. Because the left hand, the power of the left hand is dead.
Yeah. 右で打って左でつきます。右で打って左でつ
きます。この時
も持ち方がこれでは左手の力が死んでし
まう。 So in this case
は左手を小指半分かかっていればこの平が
Connecting the palm of your hands to the end of the sword in each thrust.
今度は先ほどよりもちょっとやりにくいですよ。
This is a little bit harder to do than the one we did just before.
はい。
You can try it.
いいかな。
Okay.
それから、
From here.
ちょっといいですか。ちょっと少し。
Please sit down a little bit, please.
ちょっと。昨日もちょっと申し上げましたけども。
So ever since I said this yesterday too.
対立にしろ、剣にしろ、杖にしろ、正しい技というのは正しい姿勢から生まれる。
So in all the techniques, whether it's weapons or body techniques, they are all born from correct posture.
ですから、腰が引いて、
you're pulling out your hips here.
鉄筋を持つ。
It becomes, it's a strange position. It's pulled back hips. You can't transfer your power with a form like that. You have to form correct posture. Same as I said before. As if to be able to transfer all the power of your body, from your entire body, to your opponent. Really, full conviction in the thrust. And you should really be extending on the back leg. It won't go through that way. Power won't go through.
Hey,
Professor Holman again. Right strike, left hand side thrust.
Okay. 情報を使って自分の心と体を鍛えるためにはやはり一つ一つの動作を真剣にやるということが大事だろうと思います。
So the importance of what Ishiyama Sensei is trying to give to you all is each and every movement to put all your feelings in it, to do it as with as much conviction as possible. That's the way he would like people to train and to, he wishes to teach you.
ついでですから、もう少し時間がいただいて、今度は踏み立ちじゃなくてね、立ち取りの最も基本的な動作だけ一つだから。
Ishiyama Sensei would like to do not kumi tachi, but the base movements in the tachi dori form.
いいですか?
Is that all right?
はい。
No? No?
はいと言えばいいです。
例えば、
So for instance,
相手が来ます。
I come to attack.
こうやって待ってたんだよ。
You shouldn't be waiting here.
待ってたんでは、
If you're waiting,
その動作しかできません。
You can only do one movement.
ですから、
Therefore,
相手が構えます。
I'm in 構え。
出てくる。
Yeah! Enter right in here.
いいですね。
Right?
今度はゆっくりやる。
Do it slowly.
相手が振りかぶった時にはもう入ってから。
You have to enter while the person is raising the sword above the head.
それを今。
There are lots of people doing tachidori in different places. In, he sees people doing this. They're waiting there. They move and the downward, together with the downward movement of the sword. Therefore, you have to do it as fast as possible. Come on. Go straight in.
You did that.
I can't hit them.
So you have to
move. You have to move quickly.
これが入り身。
This is called 入り身。
入り身と転換というのは一体になってる。
So this is called 入り身 and 転換 two movements.
転換というのは
転換 is
分かりやすいと。
これを
転換。
This is 転換。An evasive movement off to the side, circular form.
Irimi
is entering directly in.
Slippery.
I'm a little bit slippery. Slowly, please.
So
what happens is if you really do each technique with a full, with full conviction, shinken, then this won't happen.
Hi, so let me know.
Try to pair, please.
Pair.
Make a pair. Make pairs.
Hi, so let me know. 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 Hi, so let me know.
Hi, so let me know. So we're doing it in lines like this. Everybody line up like this with their partners. By repeating this over and over again in practice under these conditions, in the case of an actual bladed weapon being pulled on you, then you will have built up a reliance on the movements and be able to perform. So it's very important to make each time you practice, each rendition of your technique special. For instance, so for instance, around you in your everyday life, there's a telephone, there are telephone books. So the paper that's being used for these telephone books is probably the lowest grade of paper. You can easily rip one or two pages of paper in the telephone books. 10 or 20 at a time you could probably rip. But would you be able to rip an entire telephone book with the same pages? No matter how much each page is very, even though it's very weak. But putting all of these single pages together, weakness, will make a very, very strong whole. So by doing keiko, thinking about this manner, each repetition we do, even though it's weak, will make the whole form that strong. So for instance, if you do 10 repetitions, you should think, okay, next time I'm going to do 12 in the same period, the same length of time. Next time I'm going to do 13 repetitions in the same period, the same time. So by doing this repetition and the build-up of repetitions, then it will make you stronger, both spiritually and physically. We're entering with the right foot now.
Hey!
Isayama sensei had actually has taken more time with this kind of training than he'd actually intended, so he's apologizing for this. He'd like to continue with other techniques.
So,
we'll stand up, bow out with the sword, and bring the swords back, and then we'll continue with practice.
Okay.
So did you get some of what Isayama sensei was teaching you? Really? Stand up and we'll bow. When you grab here, we're going to be doing Hokyu O. Going from the outside.
Isayama-sensei
also explained this yesterday.
Spinal movement. He
will come towards you if you're just pulling
him.
This is no good, just doing it this way. Only doing it that way is no good. You have to take away the power that he's holding with, and then throw
it.
This is one point in Hokyu O. Okay?
こういうこともあるということで、これはね、あの、大先生が、ちょっとね、我々に教えてくれた。大先生
taught this just a little bit to his students at that time.
一般の稽古ではやりませんでした。He
didn't do it in normal practice.
たまたまね。
Just once in a while.
今日は So
because everybody is very desirable and they enjoy taking this practice, so he wants to give it to
you.
But this is actually a secret. Show it again.
Grabbing below.
From here, like we did before, if you grab on top.
この下を持たれた時には、これできない。だからこちらの手、この相手の肘を。そう、このまま私が。 この肘を決めようと思ったらいいですか？私の肩を下げてやる。一緒にやる。グリグリグリグリ。そういうことのないように。はい。
So controlling his arm and shoulder through this movement.
4強っていうのは
4強 You're controlling the pulse on the person's arm.
これは4強じゃなくて4強と反対側の
opposite point on the arm in comparison to 4強 The opposite side. Because this is practice, do it slowly, let him grab. Using the index finger and your ring finger. You're going into the outside of his wrist and grabbing.
それは
はもしこの手が持たれたままだったら入れません。
You can't go in if you're held directly here. In this position, you can't go.
この時に、
So you have to go in with the hand and the body.
あとは手この字。
And then you go.
手この字。
You go straight in on your hand.
でここが鍛えられます。
This will really have an effect on the person's arm.
昔はこういうふうにしていろんな角度から自分の体を鍛えていました。
So in the old days, you would use this kind of grip from many different positions, different forms, in order to strengthen yourself, strengthen the techniques.
学校の先生いますか?
Are there any school teachers here?
こういう。ハイスクール。
Small
chip. Oh, small chip. It's no, not half the technique. Just a small chip. でもね、子供をね、一応持って、
悪い、
悪い。
The bad kids.
叩いたら、お父さんお母さんが、
If you hit them, then the mother and father will get angry at you.
だけども、ここをちょっと持って、
You hold them like that. You can control. Say, be quiet, please. Settle down.
はい、そういうことで、私のところへは高校の先生、大学の先生、小学校の先生、いっぱい来ます。
This,
そういう人たちが悪い子供にはニコニコしてくれない。
So when teaching students who deal with larger children, teenagers, you should be performing this technique with a smile. But in order to control them, for instance,
stand up. No. You don't stand. Sensei,
stand up.
You don't stand. Okay, come on.
So you do it with a smile.
そういうふうに、ボン殴ったり、柔道みたいに投げたり。
You can't hit children. You can't like do judo throws on them. We're talking about unruly teenagers.
But I know it's very.Gentle. All time with smile. Okay? ですから相手が持ってくるただ痛めつけようじゃなくて
It's not just trying to put the hurt on the person.
正しく動いて
Correct movement.
正しく動いて
Correct movement.
はい。
うお
ーぎゅーっそうしても
That way, it'll work.
はい、トライアゲンです。
There's actually a pressure point here. He's controlling the foot. Dropping it, keeping the foot under control.
足の甲っていうのは相手がね、こっちでも構わないんですよ。見ちゃダメ。
You're not looking. Shouldn't be looking. Shouldn't be looking.But this is in Yakuhanmi.
で、こっちへ入る時も見ない。
You shouldn't be looking, even if you're going to the outside.
こうやって見てやるじゃ
ない。Not doing it by looking.
どこに足があるか分かる。
You should be able to understand and know where it is.
足の甲。
The arch of the foot here.
それをどこでやるかというと。
Where to do it?
これ。
Using your
大きい人には少し力強く。
So in with big people, you have to put in some power there.
新しい人には柔らかく。
For newer people, you just do it lightly.
いつも伝わりの気持ちを持って稽古しましょう。
So we should be trying to put in the hurt in this kind of practice.
You can
be strong. So, let me hand out to you from the side. 45 degree angle. So,
if you want to
take it,
I'm going to
go in here. Go in here.
します。
Actually, Isoyama sensei, from in the past 2 days, he's been telling us wonderful stories from the old days about O sensei. The people in Hongo Dojo actually haven't had a chance to experience or to hear these stories. So, Yonoshi sensei really thinks that this is a very special seminar for you to be able to hear all these wonderful things about O sensei. Yonoshi sensei thinks that there is actually no one more than Isoyama sensei left in the Aikido world today who's actually had hands on experience training and learning with O sensei. As we said before, he's practiced with him. He's had techniques done on him, he's actually done techniques on him. Yonoshi sensei entered the Hombu Dojo in 1953. And he received his teaching from the second Doshu, Kishimoto sensei. And this young gentleman is 75 years old, by the way. Actually, when you're 75 years of age, then you're an old grandfather.
And thanks to
Aikido, at the age of 75, he's still able to practice and to enjoy training together with you. He's happy about that. And exactly as Isoyama sensei has been talking about, the fact that your body grows older by age, but the ki is actually limitless. But you have to continue practice, no matter what.
Ki training.
Ki training.
Okay.
We'll be starting with free exercises. So this is we use our wrists a lot in Aikido. So in order to warm up and for training, we do this. 15th century. So we're in the most safe position here, going into the Taino Hinko position. So who can be attacked from here? You're standing in the attack. So at the side here, this is a... Forward. grabbing this way. Now it's here. There are two ways.
Good.
And from that position, the boys need to go.
It won't go up. You really have to turn first and then go up.
while turning, breathing him up. You will go up right from there. While turning. Then you do
the movement.
So we should consider this as being Kokyu practice in order to become better at Kokyu.
So continue.
Cutting down, holding,
He should be sending his power not to me, but all the way through me to the opposite wall.
All the
way over to the far end of the room.
Big senpai, the word.
Thereafter, if Tara Sensei and this is Johnny Moshi, we are at the top of the line here. I want to finish with there are two things left. One, you've been present, and afterwards, if you want to take a picture together with the sensei, organize yourself in dojos. Don't come individually, that will take for everyone. And then we can take some photos for your dojo. But first, Maria, we want to give you a picture. First,
tell the sensors what you're doing.